doing good things, like going to school. The first generation in your lineage to do one great thing or the other. I don't know them in this. That's in my spirit, that's how I'm delivering it. The Lord said, we should place every covenant of blood that is working against the will of God for my life. That is working against the original plan of God for my life. That by the covenant of the blood of Jesus that speaks better things. Amen. Do you know that there was an existing covenant that bans everyone that is born of a woman? That is the covenant of who? Of Adam. Inasmuch as you are born by a woman and there is blood in your stream, you are tied under the covenant of that curse of struggling. Hallelujah. Until another covenant of blood was raised to defeat and to cancel the existing covenant, there was no liberty, there was no freedom. So that is the same thing you want to raise this morning. That every existing covenant of blood in my lineage, in my family, that is designed to frustrate the life of people in my lineage, by the covenant in the blood of Jesus, I destroy them. Prayers in the name of Jesus. Symbolizes victory.
Yes.
When the Lord reveals a problem, He gives solution. He who told me to give this prayer has arranged the system of solution. And as you have lifted your voice, because the Bible says that for this reason is the Son of God manifest, that He will destroy, He must destroy, He has destroyed the works of the enemy. Every operation of darkness that is linked with your family, with the source that brought you to this world, that has connected you by blood to speak against your destiny, the original plan of God for your life. This morning, they are destroyed in the name of Jesus. For in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Let's be seated. That's the first assignment the Lord gave me to do this morning. Bible says in the book of Matthew chapter 10, verse 41.
Bible says, he who receives a prophet will get the reward of a prophet. Hallelujah. By the grace of God, I know that the Lord has called me to be a prophet of good news, an evangelist in a prophetic order. Hallelujah. And he has sent me to you this morning. Now, yesterday, I was in a boutique. I wanted to buy shoe. You know, I've bargained with the Omoibo. We've agreed on the price. And I just felt it in my heart that the Lord was saying to me that I should not buy the shoe. So I didn't buy it. I bought one, I didn't buy the other one that I wanted to buy. So I didn't understand the reason why God would say I should not buy shoe. Hallelujah. So that was in the afternoon. At the evening yesterday, the Lord told me that as I'm coming today, that I should buy pure bliss. How many of you know pure bliss? You know pure bliss, right? You know, and me, I'm not a fan of that mosquito. So it's not like I don't eat it at all, but I can count the number of times I've tasted that biscuit. You know, so it's not like it's a choice for me. I'm indifferent. Hallelujah. So yesterday evening I bought it. And okay, please, someone should open this black line up. Wait now. Today is not my birthday. My bed here, yeah, we need your gun. Now, for me to understand, this is it is prophetic. It is prophetic. Hallelujah. Now, for you to know that it was systematic. You know, when I wanted to buy the biscuits, I wanted to buy like 3 cartons and because I traveled to Shaki yesterday, so I got back to Lagos around 10 p.m. So most of our shops are closed. I was just looking for pure bliss because I knew that it was God that said I should buy it. Amen. So I'm not sending you anywhere. Amen. So when I didn't see the complete, but I just told them to mix it with one. I didn't even know.
Praise the Lord.
So this morning, as I woke up, the Lord told me to Google the meaning of bliss on WhatsApp, on Google. It's God's instruction. So I was following foolishly because He's the one that sent us. So even though we don't understand what he's saying, still we will do what? We will follow. So I did that this morning, and as I opened Google and I typed this, the first thing that came up, the Lord said I should use it to prophesy to the house. And then, really and truly, I begin to see connection between all that the Lord I sent him to do in the house this morning. Now, I'm going to give everybody this pure bliss. I'm going to take it one by one. Hallelujah. Wait. There's what? Hey, you can hear this one. This one, only on the German. Hallelujah. So as I searched Google, bliss said supreme happiness, utter joy, contentment, the joy of heaven, and a cause of great joy and happiness. So the Lord said, as you be collecting these biscuits, it's a biscuit too. No, she can't conceal. Everyone wants to die. Only communion, you know. We shall be communion. I'll be pastor. So we will tell me, she can't conceal. Hallelujah. But as I'll be handing it over to you one by one, it will become as and as you eat it. It will become in you the seed of joy.
Amen.
The Lord said that there are some in people in this church that the enemy will just like making them sorrowful. They just get sorrowful, and events that bring sorrow usually happen in their homes. But as you eat this biscuit, it's a seed. So then let me call it biscuit again. As you eat this seed, you are eating it prophetically. You are eating it prayerfully. That's sorry, my phone. In every areas of your life, there will always be spring of joy.
Amen.
At every stage of your life, you will always find joy and happiness. Everything that hold them back in your lineage, as you eat this seed which has been sanctified by the word of God, it will carry out an unimaginable operation within you.
Amen.
And establish an everlasting pool of joy.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I know what my eyes see before I carry the biscuit to this place. It was not easy for me to carry to your cartons. I don't have a car yet. Amen. Amen. Okay, seed. God bless you. Ah, I'm wanting cash revelation. By the easing of the sacrifice that I made to bring this biscuit to this place, I'm praying passionately from the deep of my heart. By the scepter of power and authority that the Lord has handed over to me, I decree, go with this satanic thing, as you take this seed, the joy of the Lord will be established in those homes in the name of Jesus. Many of you that your academics have become a source of sorrow for you, as you take this seed, an unimaginable, a supernatural turnaround that will make that academic to give you an unending joy will come upon you in the name of Jesus. Source of finance, and it has become a source of sorrow in your life, I decree in the name of Jesus, as you take this seed of joy, helpers that will wipe away your tears will locate you in the name of Jesus. By the reason of the anointing that is going in the house right now, I also declare concerning DSL last project, this building project, because it's a joy for us to see it being completed, that by the reason of the angels that has been commissioned to the
to give joy to all under this sanctuary this morning. They shall also give to this sanctuary the joy of the miraculous completion of this project. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
For in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Amen.
Please open it. Let me share it. I have 25 minutes now, and I want to go. Preached. Amen. I hope you are enjoying the Lord. Let me enjoy by letting you give your peace. But you have seen a seed. It's a seed. Hallelujah. So, because of our time, give me your hand. I want you to dispatch. I anoint your hand. I anoint your hand. That which the Lord wants to do through my hand on the destiny and the life of these ones, I pass it to you. As you give out this biscuit, this seed, it will do that which the Lord has designed it to do in the name of Jesus. Amen. Good morning, church. It's going to see your face again. It's been a long time I've been here. And I'm happy to see these wonderful faces again. And of course, I always remember you in my prayers, always. But I'm happy to see the joy of the Lord shining on your faces. Hallelujah. And I want to thank the leadership of this fellowship, the executive, for the great work you are doing. Even in absentia, you have been holding forth. And I pray that the Lord at no time, the Lord will not leave you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The Lord will not forsake you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The Lord will not abandon you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I hope more people must carry you. Everybody needs to carry a share. You must make sure you have a bite of that seed. Of that pure juice. That other one, you can share it anyhow. Just make sure you have a bite of it. Hallelujah. Now, today is first Sunday. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
The first Sunday in the month of October. Glory be to the name of the Lord in the highest.
Hallelujah.
Glory be to God in the highest.
Hallelujah.
God who has made us to see the 10th month in year 2021. For easy, Lord. For easy. But in the midst of the thief and thorn, the Lord has spared our life. It is by His mercy we are not consumed. Glory be to God in the highest.
Amen.
Amen. I think we want to speak on the topic that says, worship at the feet of the cross. Worship at the feet of the cross. What is wrong with the light? Worship at the feet of the cross. The two things I want to establish in this lesson. The first, on a lighter mood, is the essence of worship. The essence of worship. And the third, and the second, I mean, is at the feet of the cross. Now, while I was preparing this message, the Lord told me that
The reason why it is at the foot of the cross is because in our generation today, thank God for the gospel singers that have increased in large numbers. Hallelujah. So we have a lot of chorus singers, but we have few worshippers. Am I audible? Am I communicating? We have a lot of chorus singers. We have a lot of, like, you can just sit around and just sing. We have a lot of people who are calling. And I love that lady. Not just because of her song, but because of her spirit. She's a unique messenger of God for this generation. Not in the context of what she delivers alone, but the way she raises other gospel singers. The way she creates platform for other people to rise. There is nothing that can be as godly as that. No, I love her. Let's start for her. That's going to know how much I love her. Hallelujah. Yeah, we have a lot of choir singers, just sing. But Matthew chapter 15, verse 8. Matthew chapter 15, verse 8.
Bible says, these people draw near to me with their mouths and honor me with their lips, but their heart is far from me.
Now,
the worship at the feet of the cross is not just a desire or a wish to sing. Amen. To sing at the cross means that your heart and your soul is poured out to worship God. All your desires, they are directed towards worshiping God. Not just a mere desire to sing with your mouth and with your lips. And that is why after singing, you still discover that the body that was in your heart before you started singing is still in your heart. Because you have not worshipped, you only sang a song. But the worship that transforms life. How many of you know that worship is an instrument? It's a weapon of war. Aside from the fact that it is a means to reverence God, it is also what? A weapon of war. So the reason why many hold that weapon, I think Exodus chapter 10 talks about using a blunt cutlass to cut a tree, that it requires much stress and labor. So the reason why you just sing and then nothing changes in your life, you don't experience the move of God. Because most of us, our hearts and our soul does not worship God. Hallelujah. Now, what do we mean by worship? Worship means to bow down, to kneel, or to lay face down before someone as an act of reverence. Genesis chapter 18, verse 1 to 5. The book of Genesis chapter 18, verse 1 to 5. Bible says, then the Lord appeared to him by the terebinth trees of Mamre, as he was sitting in the tent door in the heat of the day. So he lifted his eyes and looked, and behold, three men were standing by him. And when he saw them, he ran from the tent door to meet them and bowed himself to the ground. He did what?
He bowed
he bowed himself to the ground. He worshipped God. And I'm sure many of you are familiar with this story. When Abraham worshipped God, did he worship God with the intention of, I'm childless, I don't have a child? Did he? He only worshipped God because his soul is passionate to worship God. And as he was in the process of that, the Lord came and met his long years needs. So there are many burdens that many of you are carrying this morning or for a long time, that the Lord is saying that I just need your heart to be right. And I need you to worship me from the deep of your heart and live a life of worship, a life of reverence. And that's your problem. Will be solved. Amen. Amen. According to Taylor's Greek of Lexicon, that's in the Greek meaning, said, worship means kneeling or prostrating to do homage, whether to show respect or to make supplication. So, even in the process of worshiping, you are showing respect to God and you also offer your supplication. The Bible says in the book of Philippians chapter 4 verse 6, he said, be anxious for nothing, but by prayer and supplication with what? With thanksgiving. Let all your requests be made known unto God. The Hebrew lexicon defined it as a means to prostrate, to bow down before a superior, to pay homage. I just have like 10 minutes, so I'm just trying to pick the point. So worship is the acknowledging of God's glory, accepting that there is someone who is transcendent and glorious, worthy of our full allegiance and devotion. Acknowledging the glory of God, that is worship. And when you acknowledge God's glory, what happens to you? He rubs his glory on you. Psalm 29, verse 1. Bible says, give unto the Lord all glory due to his name. Exalt him in the beauty of holiness. Then Isaiah chapter 40 verse 5 now says that the glory of the Lord God is seen upon me, and all eyes shall see it, because his mouth as well has declared it. So as you worship God, you are acknowledging God's glory. And as you do that, is what? He rubs his glory on you. Amen. Now, to ascribe and give glory to the Lord, the worship must come from the heart and from the soul. Now, Psalm 103 verse 1 and 2 and Psalm 104 verse 1. I'm going somewhere. Psalm 103 verse 1 and 2. It said, bless the Lord, O my soul. Again, bless the Lord what?
Oh,
my soul. Now, what is a soul? I went further to search. The A man is composed of the spirit, soul, and what? And the body. And I discover that the soul is the place of desire. The soul is the place of ambition. The soul is the place of pursuits. The soul is the place of interests. The soul is the place of attraction. What you are attracted to, or what attracts you, what moves you. So, if your worship does not come from your soul, it means that the Lord is not in any ways in the list of your preference. It means that the Lord is not in any way in the interest of your life. Coming to church. You can be in the midst of other believers, but something has not happened to your soul that will make you a pursuer of God. That where He leads me, I will go. And that nothing in this world is sufficient to move me or take me away from God. Now, take your Bible to the book of Luke. Luke chapter 12. Luke chapter 12 from verse 15. And he said to them, take heed and beware of what?
Covetousness.
Now, whenever Jesus gives a parable, he uses that parable to address a matter. Are we together? So the matter that Jesus wants to address here is what? The matter of covetousness. He said, because one's life does not consist in the abundance of the things he possesses. So this is another matter. That's the parable that he gave. I'm trying to summarize, I'm just so I won't be able to break as I wanted to. Said, then he spoke a parable to them, saying, the ground of a certain rich man yielded plentifully, and he thought within himself, saying, what shall I do, since I have no room to store my crops? So he said, I will do this. I will pull down my barns and build greater, and there I will store all my crops and my goods, and I will say to my soul. Then, inverted comma. So, you have many goods laid up for many years. And he said, take your ease, eat, drink, and be merry. Verse 20. But God said to him, fool. How many fool do we have in the house this morning? How many fool do we have in our generation today? How many youths are living as fool in our world today? And we see how the foolish trap of the devil has turned many youths in our generation to Yahoo boys. Has turned many of our ladies to once girls. In the quest to do what? To gather. To gather what? To gather plenty, abundance, for the satisfaction of the flesh that will die one day. We see how the soul of many youths in our generation today
is filled with a lot of evil. In fact, it has become the actual rock of evil. All in the name of the satisfaction of today. Didn't you see what the rich man said? He said, take your ease. Eat, drink, and be. The Bible said in the book of Lamentation, chapter 3, I think verse 27, he said, it is good for a young man to bear his yoke while he is a youth. Do you think the scripture will change? The life, the sacrifice you do not pay while you are a youth, you will pay it while you have no strength. It is not a cost, it is the word of the Lord. Because to point lotu ye, to feel why you are alone. That same thing will make you pay the price at the time that you have no strength. And at that period, it will be too late because it will be bundles of sorrows. Worship at the feet of the cross. So the Lord is saying, give me your heart. Give me your soul. Let them be filled with the desire for me. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And what? Other things shall be added. So, give me your heart first. Give me your soul first. Let them become a source of desire for me. Let them pursue me. Seek in the Lord. Now, when he is near, when you can find him. Because a time will come, like King Saul, that you will seek the Lord, but you will never find him. The seed of evil that Saul planted at the young age of his reign did not only destroy him, he destroyed his entire generation. So the seed of evil that you are planting in your soul today, let me tell you, you are not the only one that will reap it. Even your generations that are yet unborn, they will cost you. Amen. I hope I'm not sounding too harsh. Amen. So bless the Lord, oh my soul. Until your soul consists of the abundance of God, you cannot worship in spirit and in truth. Because your desire and your passion will never be there. You can be officiating in the church, but it is a lighter fire. How many of you know lighter? Talk about the lighter. How many of you know lighter now? And so when you press lighter, how long can that fire stay? No, once you press it once, how long does that fire stay? The fire that some of you are carrying, they are only fire that will last you for this campus days. And actually, this is the time for you to set a fire that will last you through the entire days of your life. The fire that some of you are carrying, they are just fire to serve as the drama coordinator. Fire to serve as the choir coordinator. Fire to serve as whatever coordinator. And I wanted to say media coordinator. I hope God is not talking to our media coordinator.
Hallelujah. But God is saying this morning, give your soul to me. Let the desires and the pursuit of your soul be me. And every other thing that wants to take your soul away from you now, from God now, he said, you will do what? You will add them to you. Hallelujah. Are you enjoying the Lord?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Oh, I'm not sounding too harsh. All right. As I'm landing up now, okay, let me just, some of the things that I don't know if I'm be able to touch this anyway. Luke chapter 7, verse 36 to 50. We're not going to read it, because if you read it. But Luke chapter 7, verse 36, you can just open it. Open it, please. Luke chapter 7, verse 36 to 50. So just take a glance through to know the content of what is there. The first thing I want to say is that I know I'm using extra time already. The first thing I want to say is that it is at the feet of Jesus that there is salvation. Amen. Bible talked about a sinful woman. And I think Luke chapter, is it Luke chapter 7 now?
Yes.
No, there's a particular verse I wrote here. Okay, Luke chapter 8, verse 2. Luke chapter 8, verse 2 described the sinful nature of this woman. That she's a woman that was possessed with demons. Amen. So, whatever level you are in the kingdom of sin, am I communicating to someone this morning? Whatever level you are at the kingdom of sin, I'm saying kingdom of sin, no. So I'm not mentioning any sin. Maybe any kind of sin is a common name, is a common noun, right? So any level you have, no matter how deep you have gone in sin, just one thing that you need to do. Come to the feet of the cross and reference God. Bible said, verse 36, let me just take, okay, verse 38. Okay, let me take from verse 37. And behold, a woman in the city who was a sinner, when she knew that Jesus sat at the table in the Pharisee's house, brought an alabaster flask of fragrant oil and stood at his feet behind him weeping, and she began to worship his feet with her tears and wiped them with the hair of her head. And you know, the Bible says that the hair of the woman is what? Their glory. So she worshiped God with the best thing she has. She worshiped God with the most expensive oil. She worshiped God with her glory. That is, she said, Lord, I truly surrender all that is precious and important to me. Amen. I just want to, because I can't get anything, so I want to just take a verse. Then, from verse 45, Jesus said, you gave me no kiss, but this woman has not ceased to kiss my feet since the time I came in. You did not anoint my head with oil, but this woman has anointed my feet with fragrant oil. Therefore, I say to you, her sins, which are many, are forgiven. For she loved much. She did what?
She loved much. Where did that love originate from? From her heart, from her soul. The same soul that we desire to see has suddenly become a soul that wants to serve God, that wants to live for God, that wants to do the will of God. Amen. He said in verse 14, and he said to her, your sins are forgiven. As many of you that you are sink deep into the kingdom of sin, as much as you are ready to worship at his feet, all your sins are forgiven. Amen. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Now, let me just take one more as I end up. Oh, I have 6 here. Which one should I take? Okay, let me pick John chapter 11, verse 2. John chapter 11, verse 2. And I wrote here in my book that investment for unknown days. What did I call it? Investment for unknown days. John chapter 11, verse 2. And the Bible says, it was that Mary who anointed the Lord with fragrant oil and wiped his feet with her hair, whose brother Lazarus was sick. You know the story of Lazarus now. So, imagine that she had not worshipped at the feet of Jesus. Lazarus would have died and died in vain. Because for the Bible to make reference to this, it means that in that was why this description was made. So whatever you do with the Lord today is an investment for days unknown. Whatever you do for the Lord today is an investment for days that are yet unknown. And the Bible says, redeeming the time. For what? The days are evil. Amen. I want us to sing this song as we close.
Glory, fire.
I pray God will give me voice for you. Glory, hearts, God.
Beautiful.
Excellent God, I bow before your feet.
precious.
Excellent God, I bow.
As many of you are in the house this morning,
glory,
the Lord has ministered to your heart.
Beautiful King.
And you want to bow before His throne. You want to worship at His feet. Keep on. Okay. You want to worship at His feet. I want you to come forward. You want to dedicate your life. You know within yourself that the fire that you carry is not the fire that will sustain you. You know yourself that your soul is far from the Lord. You know within yourself that your soul is almost sold out to the devil. But there is salvation in the house this morning. There is a message speaking from the throne of grace this morning. I don't usually do this. I don't usually come to the house. But that is what the Lord said to me. Because Lord said He wants you to make an intentional decision to give your heart and your soul to the Lord. To give your best to the Lord. The same way this woman gave her best to the Lord. And the Bible said in John chapter 11 verse 2 that that sacrifice that she offered
spoke
when she was in a trouble in the future. You are getting this money. You want to dedicate your heart to the Lord. I want you to come forward. I want you to come before this altar. Let all eyes be closed right now.
We worship at your feet. Bow before your throne.
The Spirit of God told me that there is someone that must come out. You. The devil is there to finish you. But God is saying, I'm giving you the last platform. So come to me that I can redeem your soul.
Oh,
she bowed
to
me. That
you are the glorious God.
The Spirit of God is not permitting me to continue. The Spirit of God says, I'm thinking. Upon you the fire of the Holy Ghost afresh. The passion for Christ that is endless.
that cannot be consumed. We consume your soul right now in the name of Jesus. Those things that the enemy has used to trap you, those things that the enemy has used to tie you down, so that you will not fulfill the divine order for your life. As a prophet of good news, I have brought you the good news from the throne of grace, and you have received it. I decree a shift in your life this morning in the name of Jesus. Bible says, he who the Son set free is free indeed. From the prison of darkness, where the devil has tied you, I set you free in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. For in Jesus' mighty name we are praying. Thank God to Jesus. The whole church want to pray this prayer. Bible talk about this woman that after she offered a worship at the feet of Jesus, that Jesus said that wherever the gospel is being mentioned, that this woman must be what? Remembered. She must be mentioned. She wants to pray to God that, Father, at every time that I worship at your presence, at every time that I worship at your presence, passion to give your soul to God above every other desires of the world will consume your heart in the name of Jesus. Go in this mind in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.